Good morning from Koreatown, LA. It is Sunday? No, it's Tuesday already. Ooh, where did the time go by? I thought it'd be fun to show you guys Ktown while playing Pokemon Go.
So if you look in this direction, there's like no Pokestops, but if you turn, whoa. It's like 20 of them.
I found a great place for a Jeonju bibimbap. I've never been there before. However, I see a lot of great Yelp reviews, so I'm gonna give it a shot and see for myself.
I'd love to start the day off with bingsu, but last time I ate bingsu for breakfast, I had a stomach ache the whole day. Oh, I think my ride's coming.
Turn right onto South Harbor Boulevard.
So I just got dropped off in front of the restaurant, and I just checked to see if there's a Pokestop, and there is. Right across the street over there, you see there's a sign, it says Koreatown, and it's kind of like, you know, the Korean traditional architecture. Well, that is a Pokestop. I'm on the other side of the street now. I'm super hungry, but I gotta get my items, I guess. Although I'm not like super into this game, I still like to collect items once in a while. Put a little bit of effort at least. Oh, and there's a little plaza here. There's a travel company, a Korean travel company, and there's a restaurant. Okay, now here's a stall. Let's get our items. Yo, why is it blink? I got close to the stop, but my app is not working anymore. I've been out in the sun for only 5 minutes. I'm already sweating bullets here. Whew. See a lot of Korean grandmas and grandpas walking on the street. Well, it is Koreatown anyhow. I think you can see them behind me now. One of the things you'll notice about Ktown is every block is divided into plazas. So oftentimes they will have like a hair salon or like one restaurant, or maybe even a PC bang. And this one also has a travel company. And above there is a barber shop.
I'm sitting at the corner of the restaurant because there's only two other customers here, and I don't want to interrupt their lunch. Yeah. And for whatever reason, now I can access my Pokestop and collect my items.
And now you can actually see my screen. So let me spin it. Oh, but nothing's coming. Oh, there we go. There are things coming out. Okay. Got that, and then, oh, there was a Pokemon earlier, but it disappeared. There's another stop over here. We'll go there after we eat and then head towards Western on this street.
Actually, I purposely chose to start from the more east side of Ktown so that when I walk towards the west, my face won't burn from the sun. My back will be facing the sun.
So this restaurant is called Jeonju Dosso, Jeonju Restaurant.
Jeonju is a city in South Korea that is famous for their bibimbap.
I'm gonna go with the vegetarian one, Namul Dosso bibimbap. All right, my set of banchan, you know, the Korean side dishes, just came out. And as you can see, we have you know, our classic napa cabbage kimchi as well as radish kimchi. And here we have miyeok, which is a seaweed soup. It's really hot. That's really hot. Ooh. It's the water kimchi. My bibimbap just came in a sizzling pot, and listen to that glorious sound. You hear it? You hear it? Maybe you need to go closer to the bowl. Oh, it's getting steamy. Ooh. Oh, that was beautiful. No filter either. Wow, look at that. It looks so dreamy.
Alright, so I'm back out on the streets. I'm walking towards Western. And let me check if there are any Pokestops on the way. And it looks like there is one block from here in that direction. So we'll cross the street.
So this Pokestop is a church, the Berenda Street Baptist Church. And across the street, there's some construction going on. Let's get a spin and see what kind of goods come out. I'm gonna go back on Olympic and continue walking towards Western. And it doesn't look like there's any Pokestops on the way, but we still gotta head to that direction, so let's go.
We have a couple missions going on here. I'm trying to get as much goods from Pokestops as well as give you guys a tour of Ktown, and I really, really wanna try that dragon's breath. So we got three missions going on, and we gotta do this all before my camera battery dies or my phone battery dies. Unfortunately, it looks like the homeless situation in LA is just not getting any better. I'm seeing tents on the street. If you go to downtown LA, oh, even worse. worse. It's like Boboville. The homeless situation here, it's not something that we want to see, but it is happening. So if I see something like that, I will show you guys. Whatever I encounter, Susanghan, karaoke and bar, music center. No, I've never actually walked on this particular street before by foot. So it's kind of like I'm being like a semi-tourist here. I don't recommend walking here at nighttime alone. Even during daytime, usually it's safe. But you know, all it takes is one crazy person to make some stuff happen. All right, here's another plaza. It has a restaurant, a wellness center, a bakery, some pho, Yoshinoya. On the other side is Wako. They make delicious tonkatsu. The last time I ate there must have been 5 years ago. And in that corner is Kim's Jeonggi. That's where I get all my Korean, you know, like mixer, blenders, hair dryers, all kinds of home goods. All right, so we have two gyms coming up and another Pokestop on the way to Western. We'll stop by this Pokestop. What is that? It's a Taoljeong? I have passed by this many, many times when I used to live here. I drove by it whenever I go to my home, the Gaylord apartment in Ktown. So, oh, I see some ajushis up there. Anyhow, let's get some items. Ooh, it's hot. Let's get under the shade. This plaza is Cheonggiwa Plaza. And, oh, well, there's more restaurants. There's a massage parlor right over there. What else? A little church, it looks like, right next to the massage. Some plazas look kind of ghetto. This one actually looks pretty nice. And the tiling, the roof tiling, is sort of like the traditional Korean architecture. You know, when you go to the Korean palaces, they have those kind of tiles on the top. Alright, so the next Pokestop is two, three blocks down. So let's head over there. This building right here reminds me so much of the buildings in Korea, where there's so many signs piled on top of each other and next to each other, fighting for your attention. Lots of construction going on these days. But then again, I suppose there's always construction going on in a city such as Los Angeles. So it looks like there's a gym across the street. Is that the Hanmi Bank is a gym? Let's click on that. Oh, it looks like a mutant pineapple. Church God's Guest. Oh, it looks like there's construction going on. I don't see a church here. Anyhow, let's spin. Alrighty, some Pokemon balls. I really wanted to do the battling at the gym. I never really have done it before, but I also don't like the idea of standing around and people keep passing by me. I don't want to look vulnerable to being attacked. Although, right now it seems pretty safe. Alright, so it looks like there's one stop on the other side of the street. I shall cross the street. More Korean businesses, Korean red ginseng, Harvard, Hapadu Yakgup, Harvard Pharmacy. Alright, let's cross. Oh, I have 15 seconds. Alright, let me find some shade. This small spot of shade right here. Alright, what is this? It says Silver Lakers mural. I don't see no mural here. Okay, let's spin. Got three balls. Alright, let's continue walking. I might have lived in LA for 7 years, but I never knew there was a Koreatown US post office here. And then next door, there's a restaurant called Jukyang. This gentleman popped out and I was asking him what's really delicious there. And he was saying the samgyetang's really good. But I also learned that he is the world's first what?
Okay, so I'm the world's first Pokemon trainer manager. I have my own Pokemon trainer agency. You can sign with my agency. And I will get your Pokemon career all the way lit. You can take a look at my Pokemon. I am level 31. All fire Pokemon. You know, but the thing is, I'm actually saving all my Stardust for this Gyarados and this this Dratini that's about to go Dragonair, that's about to go Dragonite, you know? So, I'm all about mapping your long-term Pokemon career, taking you to that next level. If you're serious about becoming a Pokemon trainer, please consider me.
What's your name?
My name is Mike Gao. Mike, G-A-O, you can look me up online. very reputable on the internet.
Oh, sorry, did you want to say something more?
No, that's good, that's good.
Fantastic. Yeah. Well, nice to meet you.
Yeah, nice to meet you.
I don't know how, I'm going to trust everything you say, but I'm new to this. I have no idea. Everything you're saying, Dragon Knight, Dragonair. And you know what? I just want to say I love your hair. So can we get a 360?
Yeah, what's a 360?
Either I spin around you or you spin around.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I don't know. I feel like this is my only good angle right here.
Okay. Okay, we'll just keep it at that then. I had a nice little chat with Mike. I'm going to check out more of his stuff later when I get back home. I don't want to use all my juice right now. I'm very conservative with my batteries because if I keep my camera on the whole time, well then, my Pokemon adventure is going to die out soon. So, yeah. Well, hold on. I think there was one stop around here.
Oh, yeah. What is that one? It's the Auto Union Auto. Sounds like a car thing. Look at this. Woohoo! Got some stuff here. Let's see what other Pokestops here. Let's take advantage of this little shade.
Ooh, there are two Pokestops. What is this one? All right, this one is Koreatown Gateway sign. Where's the sign? Oh, the Gateway sign is right over there.
All right, let's grab those goodies. Got that. And there's another one right here. Dark Beauty?
Looks like a mural. Got that. What else? Okay, we keep walking. And then there's another Pokestop coming up. So, let's go! Sorry, I know you can't see my screen, but it says the next Pokestop is across the street. There's a fountain inside the Galleria Plaza.
If you go downstairs, there's a market. And then if you go upstairs, that's where the food court is, as well as that fountain where that Pokestop is located. So here we go. Actually, this is perfect timing because I started to get thirsty. So after we get the goodies from here, we'll go downstairs, grab a drink, and then head back out. And here's that fountain. This is one of the plazas that my parents and I would always come to whenever we drive into LA. And when you get up these stairs, you'll be led to the food court, and it is lunchtime, so it's gonna be a lot of people. We have something called Snow Monkey, Tofu Monkey. While you eat, you can watch Korean dramas on the screens. Yeah, over there we have a bunch of noodles, all sorts of Korean food. Pretty affordable. I mean, a lot of these dishes here, they'll charge about 10 bucks. If you go with like meaty options, then it's gonna be like, what, $12, can be upwards. If you get a simple bibimbap, then easily it's just like 8-9 bucks. And here we have clothes, shoes. This one's called Young Art, bunch of stationery inside. Downstairs, they have two cosmetic shops, one called Palace Beauty, other one called Cosmetic World. Oh, that ginseng looks like a person. Let's stop by the market and then we'll continue our walking outside. It is a hot day and I'm starting to get dehydrated. So I was thinking it would be so awesome to get a banana milk, but it looks like they only sell it in big packages. I'm gonna ask someone to see if they sell singles. So it turns out they do not sell single packs, only 6 packs and 3 packs and dozen packs. I'm just gonna get a small bottle of water. Alright guys, I'm back outside and there's a Pokemon stop really close. It's that Mew up there. So I'm gonna go over there. Just finished all my water. Super hot and I'm just looking for shade constantly. So I'll probably end up going to like 5 more Pokestops. I'm here at this stop. So let's catch some goodies. Alright, so it's almost 1:30 p.m. I am too excited to not leave this shade, but gotta get out of a comfort zone. What I'm noticing is there are a bunch of people who are walking in this little piece of shade, and when there's another person coming ahead of them, they just walk around them and get back into this little mini shade road. More mixed apartments starting to be built. Well, it looks like we're close by another Pokestop, so let's take a look. It's El Diablo. Oh, it's too far away. We gotta cross the street. Looks like there's an Alienware promotion there. They had a concert here at the Wiltern recently. this Pokestop is also located inside the plaza. Actually, we have access to it right now, so let's spin. I'll still show you the inside of the plaza. This plaza's design is a little different. They have another floor. On the right, there's a bakery and some areas where you can sit down. Here, you have a K-pop music shop. You can buy all your items and your K-pop goods. I was asking all the businesses in Koreatown Plaza, like, where is this dragon's breath everyone's talking about? A lot of people are like, what are you talking about? I have no idea what this is. And finally, there's this one guy at a stationery shop saying, oh, that's actually on Western and Wilshire at another plaza. So I'm walking there right now. It's like about 5 blocks, I want to say. Well, this is a kind of cool plaza. It's stepped. So let me show you. It's kind of strange, but cool at the same time. Looks like they have a skincare shop, more restaurants, Korean barbecue. I'm looking for shade, but there's no way to stay in shade. Even this tree is wimpy. It can only keep you half cool. So I found a little shade here. There is another Pokemon stop. Let's see if we can get some items from there. It's a little too far away, huh? All right, we're getting really close to the Dragon's Breath. And this here is a Wilton Theater, which Illionaire recently performed at, as well as other K-pop stars like Wonder Girls. That. So this one's a City Scene Power Box, which is across the street. Oh, the Pepsi truck is currently covering it, but let's take a spin. Click some balls. All right, let's check out what this gym is about currently. Level 1, I guess I could play that. Oh, there's nothing there. What do I do? Do I add something there? Well, it's my first time encountering an empty gym. What do I choose? How do I know which one to choose? Oh, Cubone. Yes. Error? What? What's that? What? There's other people there? What do I do? Do I just hit it? When do I know when to hit it? Oh my gosh. Oh my god, what am I doing? What do I do? What's happening? Oh my god, he's hurting me. I'm gonna run. I lost. Okay, anyhow, let's go get some Dragon's Breath. This is the Madang Plaza. Oh, they have Beery Papa, Boba Time, an H Mart, cosmetic shop. What is that? Hansol Naengmyeon. Hansol Naengmyeon. So they sell naengmyeon? Bari Baguette. Daiso, and above they have a theater. Ooh, this is a very narrow escalator. Reminds me of the ones in Korea. This is a bingsu shop, curry house. What else is there? If you look closely, on that wall, it's all painted. Korean style, old school Korean style. My battery's running out, I must recharge. So I found the chocolate chair just in time before my battery completely died out. I still have about a good minute to film. This is what it looks like. Looks pretty cool, yeah? It looks like dry ice. They say not to drink the liquid on the bottom or else it's gonna burn. It's gonna feel like burning. I'm sitting outside because inside, well, there's a lot of people. It's pretty packed. And I ordered it comes with a couple sauces or different dips. And this one's a strawberry. And this one is the chocolate one. So, it's my first time trying this. Some of my friends tried it and they said it tastes pretty nasty. So, I'm not gonna have too much high expectation for this.
Hello! You're a YouTuber, right?
Yes!
I've always watched you. Can I take a picture with you?
Sure! If I take a picture with you, do you want to try this with me?
Hi, I'm Chelsea.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
It's my first time meeting Chelsea. And have you had this before?
Yes, I have.
Yes, you have. So, do you mind if I dip it and feed you first?
Okay.
So this time you're going to feed me.
Okay.
She's gonna dip it in the strawberry one.
Ready?
And oh, nothing's coming out. It tastes like cereal.
Like a cereal, and you just dip in whatever it tastes. is.
Well, thank you so much for feeding me, Chelsea.
Thank you.
I was hoping to have a friend with me to do this.
Thank you so much.
Maybe I need to refill on the dry ice because nothing was coming out of my mouth. All right, so I got a refill on my nitrogen. So this time, let's hope it works. Is don't bite first and then blow it out of your mouth. Keep it in your mouth and then the smoke will come out. Check out the outside of this cup. It is completely frosted over. It is winter in this cup. I'm back at my friend's place to recharge my camera battery. I hope you guys enjoyed the Pokemon adventures today. As you can tell, I'm quite the noob. We didn't run into too many Pokemon today. But once again, this video is not just about the whole gameplay. It was a fun way to explore Ktown, LA. I'll see you guys next Wednesday. 안녕! Check it out, you guys. If you take a ball all the way at the bottom, it's the coldest, right? Because it's near all the nitrogen. So let's get a ball all around the bottom. And if you put it inside a sauce, it goes cray cray. Look, it crackles and it bubbles and whoa.